my dear students, welcome back to this mini HS school. I believe you are all happy and safe at home. Once again, welcome you all back to the social studies class. So today, this is all about your weekly test. I'm not only going to explain what you have performed in your last class and also about think for your further test. Because please take the first thing, the first foremost thing is please take it that is a serious format, because we are registering your marks. We are keeping it in account. So it talks a lot about you. So please make sure that you are sure about your answering pattern and things. I know that you are answering in your phones, iPads or tablets or in laptop, so the typing is a little bit difficult for you, but please make sure you are writing the correct answer. Clear? Fine. So let's think about that today. So today's class is going to be like that, and I'm going to explain certain answers that I feel that you are facing some issues in that part. So let's start our class. The first thing, name of the student. I asked the first question is like name of the student. The previous examination, like weekly test I conducted, or I think revision test or something, I just asked like, what is your name? I just checked how you are formatting a sentence. But most of the students just wrote their name. Like they didn't, what is your name? And since you have to write like, my name is this and this. But most of the students just wrote their name. But here, let's talk about the Friday's weekly test, fine? My last Friday's weekly test. There, I just asked like name of the students. Name of the students in the sense you have to write your name, only your name, not the sentence. But there, please write your full name. I don't know why students are skipping their first name, last name. I don't know why. Please write down your full name. That's very important. Then some students writing their only first name or last name. I'm just trying hard to find your name. I'm just asking with your class teacher, discussing with her, who's this child? So please don't do that to me. It's really hard for me to find your real names, because we are not in persons. I just know you only by seeing you all in Zoom. I only know very few students, because I just met them while submitting papers or in Zoom. Other students, I don't know. So please don't do that to me. Please write down your full name with initials. You all have initials. Why I said that is Malayali people usually don't have initials. Some people, because they just add their father's name. Like, so they don't add initial with them. Only father's name. Sometimes initial they are just the mother's initial. So first letter of the name. So there are many things for Keralites. But for us, we usually add initials. I don't know, many students will have initials. Not like father's name or son name. So please add your initials. That's very important. Fine. You're practicing from here onwards. Be sure about that, okay? And then while writing, please take care of your typings. For a few things like spelling mistakes, I reduced marks. I don't know how I can give you marks, because it's an online test and all that. You have to be careful about your typing. And then I received certain students sending me the answers again and again. Like 4-5 times. A same paper I'm receiving like 4-5 times. If the form is asking you to like submit the record, your responses has been recorded. The first thing it will display on your phone, and then like another response. Don't go for another response. You can ask me whether ma'am I submitted or not. I can check it and tell you. But please don't do this. Like you're sending me again and again. I don't want to mention the student's name. Like I'm receiving more and more answers from one student. Fine. Please avoid that. Next. And then another one more thing is I'm receiving like 2-3 answers from the same student. I'll always pick first one first. Like if someone is sending me three answers, and the answers in their form is different. Like first one is different, second unknowingly someone will send. That's what I said before, like 5-6 times. But this is different. In first form, they send me some other answers, like sometimes wrong answers, and in second response, they send me like right answers. Tell me that the first one is wrong and the second form is right. Which I should select? First one or select second one? Obviously first one. I will not go for the second one. I will not even see that, because I know that the first one must be recorded one. It's for your school purpose, and the others I neglected. So first one, don't please correct your answers in second form and sending me. It doesn't do any changes. Please go only for the one form, and that must be right. And the first question, what is heritage? I really appreciate the students who try to write in their own sentences. That's good. That's pretty good. But make sure that you are writing in correct sentence formation. You have to be careful about your grammar formation. Okay, fine, it's a social land. Sometimes you may not care about the grammar. But the thing is, we are studying in ICSE school. English was very important to us. So grammar formation in social is also very important. So fine, I'm not talking about grammar. Sentence formation, at least simple grammar work. Basic grammar work. So like, you can think and write. For example, I received an answer and I don't want to share the student's name. Fine. I believe you received your marks and I got more comments from students why I didn't got this mark, that mark. So we'll come. Fine. I got an answer from a student like this question. What is heritage? What is heritage? And that student answered me like, heritage means the history and tradition which a country or society has held for many years from form its heritage. See, he starts the question answer with heritage and ends the question answer with heritage. So how I can give the full mark for that? Because see, the answer is like, I gave you the answer is like the history and tradition which a country or society has had for many years forms its heritage. Fine. If you are neglecting this and forming new sentence, it's okay. You can write like this. This is my answer for you. You can write like this. Heritage means history and tradition which a country or society has held for many years. That's all. Keep a very big full stop there. If you are making heritage in front of the sentence, you have to finish there in years. If you are making the same thing what I have given you, that's right. Don't put heritage in front of the sentence and ending the sentence. That's really wrong. But I didn't reduce the full mark. I reduced like one mark. Fine. Another one important thing. See, I managed the marks with the questions. Since it's a weekly test, I don't want to burden into you like monthly test. So it's for 20 marks, and so I don't want to burden you. That's why I made that in a simple questions, but I increased the marks. But for your midterm test process, the answer, the mark for allotted for short answers is like 2 or 3. 2 or 3. And for brief, like a detailed question answers, like 5 marks or 8 marks. I'm not confirming anything now, just I'm saying like, for sure, one words are like off mark or one mark, not more than that. But for your weekly test, I increase the mark just to encourage you. See, just to encourage you, that's all. Just to encourage you and not put you all into some burdens. So just the form to encourage you, I increase the mark. Other than that, one words are like one mark or off mark. I abundantly gave you like more than one mark, but still you are making mistakes. Please careful while you are writing your examination. Fine. So I explained like what is my heritage. So I'm sure that the student who made the mistake got my point, right? Yes. So don't add heritage like two ways. You can add that in front of the sentence or at the end of the sentence. That's your wish. You can make your own answers. I'm not stopping that, but make sure you're forming the correct sentence. Your sentence pattern must be correct, right? So this is a, let's go for the next question. It's like, so this is a one word question. Our classical music is broadly divided into Hindustani and dash music. It's Carnatic music. What's the spelling for Carnatic? What's the spelling for Carnatic? C-A-R-N-A-T-I-C. Carnatic. C-A-R-N-A-T-I-C. I reduced a few marks for some students. Like they started with K. Actually, it's C. 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 And in between, they made some mistakes. Like spelling mistakes, I reduced marks. I'm sorry for that because you have to develop yourself. Spelling is important in language. So, Carnatic music is like C-A-R-N-A-T-I-C. I want to teach you like grade 1 students. You're grown-up students, right? So, you can pick it up. So, Carnatic is the spelling is like this. So, and some answers like classical and other some answers like cultural music. No, Carnatic is the right answer. And the next question goes like, Tayam and Dandiya are examples of dash dance form and most of the students wrote right answer. It's folk. F-O-L-K, folk. That's right. Then the Vedas. Actually, it's match the following answer. But I made that in a choose form. So I am sure that I'm pretty sure that students understood that. So the Vedas is actually religious literature. Rig, Veda, Shama, Atharva, there are few things, four books. So those are religious literature. We studied that. Yes, literature form we studied. The Vedas is actually literature, religious literature, and I received some wrong answers too. Fine. Next question is like Bharatanatyam and Kuchipudi. Are examples of Bharatanatyam and Kuchipudi is we know that it's not folk dance forms, it's like classical, because Bharatanatyam under the classical dance, we know that Bharatanatyam is famous in Tamil Nadu, so we know that it's a classical form dance. Fine. Next question is like Kathakali, we know that a dance and a famous classical dance in Kerala. It's very famous in Kerala. Classical dance form of Kerala. It's very famous in Kerala. The seventh question. Dash is a folk song sung to welcome spring. It's a very important question. Dash is a folk song sung to welcome spring. Please answer me this question. It's Hori. Fine. H-O-R-I. Hori. And many students answered me like Hari. It's not Hari. You wrote just simply like A. You changed instead of O, you made that A. It's Hori. So the answer is Hori. Clear? So and I received some other answer. Chau. Chau is a folk dance. Yes. This is music. So please clear about your question. Yes, before answering the question, please read it one, not once, like twice, thrice. Read it again and again, the question. So that only you understand that what the teacher is asking you. Fine? So the answer for that question is Hori. H-O-R-I. Hori. Clear? So please don't make this mistake again and again. I thought of making a video on your midterm examination. But yeah, I didn't do that part. Only Manjika ma'am did that. So I don't want to interfere there. That's why I didn't make. And so here, weekly test. So I can make because I did this part, right? So just clear it. This is not about only social examination. Please follow that and throw out your exams, all your exams. That will help you. That will really help you. So this one is Hori, not Hari. Not Hari or some other Chau or it's Hori. Fine. Next question is goes like Madhubani. It's a folk painting. Madhubani is a folk painting and this is the right answers. Paintings and stories are a part of our dash heritage. Cultural heritage, CULTURAL. And again, I received many spelling mistakes in this cultural. I don't know what's their big deal in cultural. CULTURAL. It's cultural. So please make sure while writing, spelling, especially for me, myself, I'm just talking about social here. Myself, spelling is very important. I will always give more pressure on spelling part because history, civics, geography, and totally a package, social studies, it's really, the words are really tough. Because we have like more old names, like monument names, building names. So words, wordings are really tough here. So if you are really here mastering in spelling part in this social, you can master anywhere. Fine. So just take your part in spelling and be sure that you are answering the answers really with the correct answer. And also correct spelling. And most of the students, like many students, got 19.5. Why? The mistakes goes to your maybe spelling part. See, 20 marks is a perfection. If you are making a small mistake too, I cannot give you the full mark. And one thing, if you are having two names, I can give you an example name. Suresh Kumar. How to write this? Suresh Kumar, a same name. And I don't have here space, I just wrote here. Suresh Kumar is capital letter again. K is also a capital letter. Please make sure that K is also a capital letter. You are not using capital letters correctly. So S is, S starts with capital. So Suresh starts with capital letter. S is capital letter. And again, Kumar. K is also a capital letter. Many students writing like you are starting with your capital letter and here your second name goes like small letter. Don't do that. First name, capital letter, last name, capital letter. If you are having three names, like first name starts with capital letter, middle name starts with capital letter, and last name starts with capital letter. Clear? This is a very small thing. So please be careful about the minute mistakes. So 20 out of 20, 20 marks is a perfection. So if you are making small blunder mistakes, I cannot give you the full mark. That's why many students got 19.5. Clear? See, I'm really strict in correcting your papers. It doesn't mean that I'm not like a liberal. I'm liberal to my students. Why am I liberal? You can write your own answers. You can make your own answers. But make sure you're forming a correct sentence as well as spelling. This is the only thing I need. You can make your own answers, but it must be correct. Clear? So feel free to ask me. You can call me at any time. You can ask me your doubts. Till now, only the doubt parts, Lahuantala called me. Yeah, one day Amish called me. And another day, Jaden called me. So Amish actually, on the day, I couldn't answer her. But after I answered. So this is the thing. Like WhatsApping in me doesn't suits me all the time. Because I cannot go to the messages and see all the time. Because of the things I'm receiving daily basis. So you can call me. Better you can call me and you can ask me or not. Whatever, that's okay. I'm here to help you. See, teachers are here to only to help you. Please mark that we are here to help you. Fine? So the first question, let me go for the passing part, like short answers. Like, what is heritage? In the answer, the history and the tradition which a country, a society has had for many years forms its heritage. Or else you can write like heritage means history and tradition which a country, a society has had for many years. That's all. So both are the right answers. And name the various components of natural heritage. You know the answer, that's on page number 59. Name two types of religious monuments, so are a part of our heritage. Give one example of each. Answer is what I have given you. Temples, mosques, gurudwaras, churches, chaityas and monasteries are the religious monuments. Golden temples and jama masjids are examples of religious monuments. So there, that you can see in page number 59. So you can take your own answer from there. Even you can take your own answer. Fine. So the next question goes like, what is a folk dance? Give two examples. Fine. Here, you can see in page number 60. Folk dances are performed. For this question, see, they ask only two examples. So, you can make your own example here. Like, there you have your like chal, dandiya, theyam, cheka, kutu, and those things are there. You can take any two. So, fine. So, these ways you can read the answer and you can answer it on your own. For also for detailed answers, you can read it again and again and take your own form of answer. So, this is all about the weekly test. And hereafter, so I don't want to miss my classes, like my regular classes. So, today it's like it's departed from regular classes, right? So, we talked about the past thing, like weekly test. So, this mistake should not happen again. So, I don't want to talk about this again. Fine. So, my dear students, please make sure that you are following my guidelines that I have given you just before. Fine. So, from next test, I'm expecting a perfection. I can feel that you'll do that. Yes. So, okay, students, this is all about today's class. So, today's class is all about weekly test, and also about our lesson. We saw something about our lessons too, like heritage, our heritage. So, I'm glad that I am feeling free now. So, this is now transfer towards you. Now, this is your part to do. Fine? Yeah, I'm expecting from you. So, thank you, children. Take care. Bye-bye.